Hello YouTube, today at powerjackrepair.org we got a Gigabyte p35x v7 motherboard here for the power jack replacement. It seems like there was a damage to the board in general and the jack itself. It shouldn't look like that. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna remove this jack from the motherboard and put this jack into the motherboard. We have the video on how to take this laptop apart and do this same kind of repair, but this is basically a video about how you do the jack repair itself. If you need to take a laptop apart, please refer to the video that we got on our channel. Again, just click on our channel and type in the p35x v7. The jacks for that model we're gonna sell at the link below as well. The jack is like that, it's a brand new jack. So the first thing that you wanna do is insulate the area with the captain tape. The captain tape is also available from the link below at the Amazon website. And the reason you wanna insulate the area with the captain tape is simply because, you got a whole bunch of components, the small components right there in the back that can fly off the motherboard. I already insulated the board with the tape, so not to waste your time. On the other side, there is not much here. Also, it seems like we got a crack here on the motherboard, so the board itself is cracked right here. Right there. So we'll try to preserve that crack. We'll try to remove the jack without breaking the arm off, but no guarantees. I mean, I'm not a magician, so to speak. And once I put the jack in place, the new one, once I install a new jack in place, we have to, whoever gonna assemble it back, the person who sent it to us, they would need to use hot glue to make sure that this is gonna be a lot more stable right there. All right, so the way how to desolder this connection is you need to put a whole bunch of flux. The link to the flux is at the description below. A whole bunch of flux, then you're gonna put a whole bunch of leaded base solder. The solder that's in there right now is unleaded base solder, but we're gonna add some flux and some leaded base solder. The reason we add the leaded base solder so that the melting temperature gonna drop down, so that the hot air station would be able to easily remove this jack from the motherboard. It's gonna just drop like that. All right, so let me show you how I'm gonna do that. All right, so what we got here is some flux that we add to the arms. And now we're just gonna add a little bit more solder. The type of flux I use is at the link below. The type of solder I use is at the link below. And here, we're just gonna add a whole bunch of solder right there, whole bunch of solder right there, whole bunch of solder. You know what? It seems to me that the solder that was there isn't even leaded based solder because everything flows so easily. All right, now we're gonna add some hot air to the rear right there. Because that side, you don't really need much air. This side right here, you need some air. And this is where I'm just gonna be pressing down with the soldering iron. All right, so let's see if the hot air station would be able to drop it off from the motherboard by itself without usage of anything else here. Let's drop it even more. Okay. Okay, like that. Let's remove the heat And now let's remove the solder from the motherboard, like that, and like that. I think I needed to leave more heat on the motherboard. All right. Come on. Alrighty, so here we got desoldering some solder from the joints. And right there, I don't want to be pressing on this side here because it's a cracked side. We're gonna flip this guy over. Like that. And you see, we got a broken pin right here. There is another hole. All right. So to get this broken pin, the pin that broke in the back of the jack, you're just gonna use some pliers to lift it up. But first I need to make sure it has enough heat. I don't wanna remove the pad. All right, like that. Okay, so what I don't like here is the way how there's so much solder in here and right there. So I'm gonna add some more solder there. And let's see if we can get the solder out now like that. And like that. Doesn't want to come out here. Okay. So let me try a slightly smaller braid. Okay, the smaller braid picks up everything much better. We're gonna flip this guy over. And let's do... Okay, just making sure that the remaining stuff is off the motherboard. Wonderful. Set that aside. Gonna add some flux right there. That's the old jack, that's the new jack right here. Gonna put the new jack in place. Solder it from the top right here. All right. And on the other side, we're gonna solder it right there. All right, good job. And the last touch I want to do is I want to solder the back pin from the top right there. And for that, I need to add as much flux as I can right there. Okay. Into the back of the pin. And let's solder this guy up. Okay, wonderful. Here. Right there. Let's do right there. Good job. Really good job. Now let's remove all of that stuff. And let's make sure that those guys have enough solder to conduct the electricity. All right. Okay. All right, and let me clean up the motherboard. Again, that's the old jack. That's the new jack. Alrighty, so this is the way how the final job looks like that. You see, better than factory. And the last thing we need to do is to basically plug in the plug. That you see how already used up this plug is. I wonder if I have any other plugs here. I do, but by the time I find it, well, that's not the right one. Okay, I do, but by the time I find it, ooh. All right, I see that, yeah, that crack isn't really that great. So here, let's see. All right, so as you can see, we set it to ohms, and we get resistance on the plus. Here, basically, we can just put the black probe on the ground. So we get resistance on the plus and we get no resistance on the minus. That's how it's supposed to be. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave a like, subscribe if you have exactly the same motherboard, ship it away. If you have exactly the same laptop, you could ship it away or fix it like I just showed you. For instructions on how to take it apart, please watch the other video that much lower quality, but at least we had it already. Thank you guys. Leave a like, subscribe, have a good day.